So a little bit about your organisations, but we're here to talk about scaling. So while you're talking, Michael, so tell us, what are the challenges you had? Actually, we might go to you, Kesley, because you're earlier in the journey. So you're 9 months in and you're just at the start of your scaling journey. So tell us about some of the challenges and how you're scaling your operation.
So a couple of challenges up front was I suppose people's resistance to this concept of RPA and the idea of bots and they're going to take over the world. So we've had to do a marketing exercise going out in all the different departments and having these conversations with individuals, outlining what is RPA, how can it impact you, what's the benefit of RPA, and how to identify RPA processes. So by the end of that little hour meeting, I'm up on the whiteboard writing down RPA opportunities, and then I'm following up with them to make sure that those are applicable. From the flip side, it's actually some of the architectural stuff we've struggled with. So getting our orchestrator live, getting it through the IT governance teams, and moving some of those componentry from on-prem to cloud. So with that, there's been some IT security challenges. Mm. And I'd really say, it's been said time and time again, but really engage with your IT security team early, just to make sure that they are across all the principles, your IT architecture team, so they're across the principles. But also I think, winning the hearts and minds of people is so important, because all these videos we've seen today have tried to touch on emotional threads with all of us, saying that these bots are here to give us more time so we can do the more human things. But those human connections occur from the time you start building the automations with the people on the ground, connecting with them as if they're people, showing them the benefit of what's going to come out the back of that, and then working with managers to show those individuals that when this time is available, how can you upskill or reskill or reallocate people so that they're able to engage in more meaningful work, not have a political win where they reach over to another department and scoop up all this other low-value work and bring it into their team so that they, they get the little notch on the shoulder. So I think it's just taking everyone on that journey and making sure that they're part of the exercise.
I mean, you're thinking about getting on the academic... Newcastle's getting on the academic alliance.
That's right. So we've had many conversations about that, and we reached out again to the guys today to get that set up. But, I mean, the position descriptions of the future, I see automation as part of that. You'll be employed to do a job and be given the tools to try and automate as much as possible so that you can spend time with customers, or in our case, students or researchers. Mm. But you want to be able to add that humanistic touch out to the marketplace. And if you can automate all those mundane, minutia-based activities, why not?
Taking that to light, you mentioned about having the academy and then enabling your people, embedding the capability. We at Optus, we're actually taking that step already. We have partnered with UiPath, and we have created what we call an automation academy, for stumbling. And I'm actually looking at the PM in the crowd right now, who led and delivered this initiative with our UiPath partners up the back and our customer success managers. So we're very proud to say, and I'm very proud to say I was a key player, in driving out that capability to our organization. So what we did was we took a cohort or a segment of people and we put it out to our organization and said, hey, we want to upskill you. We want to bring you on the digital journey. We want to, build on your capability. So we created a curriculum with three pathways. One, developer. Two, business analyst. Three, change manager. We said anybody is open to join this. We don't have any prerequisites. Anybody, frontline staff, C-suite level executives, that's fine. Come aboard. And again, through partnering with UiPath, we were enabled to actually formally certify them, by way of delivering an initiative. So really it's about putting the tools out there to your people, bringing them on a journey. We set out a little bit of a guideline in terms of your different phases and toll gates that you go through of any automated solution, and the results were absolutely amazing. They really were. And this was all delivered within a six-month program. So the 400 people who first signed up to the first cohort, we culled it down to 60, and those 60 people are now certified in their respective pathways, which is amazing. So embedding the internal capability and obviously employee engagement has been astronomically huge.